The Lord is here. The Lord is here. The Lord is here.
Ask the Lord for forgiveness.
Repent of your inner sins. Repent of your sins. Expose them before God. And I want you to forgive all those you have grudges against. I want you to forgive everyone. And I also want you to forgive yourself. I want you to forgive yourself. Pray for forgiveness and forgive others. Ask the Lord to forgive you. Let us pray in this direction. Lord, forgive us. Forgive us, oh Lord, for our shortcomings. Forgive us, oh Lord, for our wickedness. Lord, forgive us. And Lord, use us. Lord, forgive us. And I forgive all those who may have grudges against, knowingly or unknowingly. I set them free. For so on the jet of my life, a shadow.
Shall not hold you anymore. Whatever is holding you shall not hold you anymore.
hearts open to God. Your hearts open to God. Only position yourself to receive. It is in such moments that people are too busy focusing on other things. That God, that you ignore God.
the fellowship of them. And what I want you, come. Healing words. So come. Do not do that. You will spoil your life and affect your destiny. I know it's been hard for you at home, but do not go. start to pray for your family before this conference ends. You must give your life to Christ. Jesus Christ loves you. Amen. There's a guy in here. They call you Young Thug. Sometimes by your friends. You are about to associate with bad gangs which will spoil you forever. Do not go in that direction. You can make a better future. The Lord is calling you to ministry. He is calling you to Himself and to work for Him. Before this conference ends, you must give your life to Christ. Anyway, let me try and do what I can in this sermon, which I will not do since I'm left with what? Five minutes? 3 minutes? Anyway, my sermon title is Transform People, Transform Nations. Transformed people transform nations. The scripture I'm reading is from 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. But we all with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. And all of us as with unveiled face, because we continue to behold in the word of God as in a mirror, the glory of the Lord, are constantly being transfigured into His very own image in ever-increasing splendor and from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord who is the Spirit. Amen. Your level of expectation determines your manifestation. So I hope you are expectant of God today. I hope you are expectant of God today, because now is that time to move from glory to glory. Where your revelation stops is where your worship ends. When God speaks, everything hears. The devil doesn't fight common sense, he fights a revelation. This is because a revelation can change the earth. You must understand that the Lord is seeking after true worshippers, those that worship Him in spirit and in truth. Worship also gets the attention of God. This is because He is worthy of all worship. Worship and obedience to God is what gets His attention, and His love for you is what releases manifestation. From that manifestation, it takes you into transformation. It is only when you are being transformed from glory to glory that you start to affect and affect your surroundings. Do not be defined by your circumstances, but be defined by the measure of your heart. The measure of your heart is the measure of a man. Worship God even when things don't seem right. Worship is the attitude of your heart towards the heart of God. When you worship Him even in the hard times, something about you changes. Your strength starts to be changed. You start to be renewed from glory to glory. All of a sudden you want to praise God. All of a sudden you want to pray. All of a sudden you want to sing a song to God or even dance. Some are looking for various solutions, yet the answer is in the person. That person is Jesus. He is the solution to all of your problems. It's interesting that people are looking for the spectacular of the supernatural. And yet you forget that the Holy Spirit living in you is supernatural. The inner witness of the Holy Spirit is very supernatural. Know your spiritual gifts. You must know how they work and what they are for. You know, believers must not be ignorant. Do not be ignorant to the spiritual. The spiritual world, the spiritual realm, it is real. But for you, you are only focused on one side of the supernatural. There are two sides of the supernatural. There's the kingdom of God and the kingdom of the enemy. The one they call Satan. So you must understand, you know, I have something against some people. It's amazing how people can believe that they are witches, yet fail to believe that there is God. You can believe that they are Satanists, yet you fail to believe that there is God. You can believe in evil spirits and ancestral spirits, yet you cannot even believe that they are angels. It's amazing. The only thing you discern is evil spirits. When shall you discern angels? When shall you discern the presence of God? When shall that come? Your gift is what gives you your ability. Your calling is what gives you your identity. Your anointing is what gives you your purpose. Do not underestimate the anointing upon your life. The anointing is operative and powerful to help lead people to Christ Jesus. Your gift is based on what you do. If you do not use it, it will never grow. If you are a prophet, it's not what you do, but it is who you are. The difference being, the spiritual gifts of the Holy Spirit are gifts that enable you to function under the action of the Holy Spirit. Then the prophet is the gift. Therefore, take care of the apostle, the prophet, the evangelist, the teacher, and the pastor, because they are the gift. They are the gift. If you are a prophet and someone tells you to stop being a prophet, you cannot stop being who you are. Therefore, know who you are in Christ Jesus and be the best you can be in Him. God has something placed in you which He wants you to fulfill, and only you, not a carbon copy or a puppet of anyone else. But God wants you to find out who you are in Him so that you can know your identity. When you know who you are, you cannot be the same. I'll end with this. I'll end with this. I had a lot to say, but no time. I'll end with this. Moses had a burning bush, but I have a burning book. And that burning book is the Bible. God took up the form of a burning bush, but Moses became the burning bush. That carried God to the nation of Israel. That's why he didn't go back to the bush. He became that which God was consuming. When we stop putting ourselves on that altar, we stop dying to self, and we stop carrying our cross. No wonder the anointing is by measure. When you stop putting yourself on that altar, you are no longer consumed. You stop dying, and you remain with the old wine. May you stand. I love Hebrews 12, which is true. Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross and the sufferings, and is seated at the right hand of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.